Hi, my name is Bintu and today I'm going to teach you how to create a doubly linked list. I'll be making a C program for creating a doubly linked list. This doubly linked list is also known as two-directional linked list. I assume that you've seen my earlier videos of single linked list. If you haven't, please visit the attached link to see all the programs for creating single linked list, traversing it, deleting and inserting new nodes in single linked list. The main difference between the doubly and single linked list is that in single linked list, you had only one pointer, next pointer, which was enabling you to just traverse in only a single direction. It was only possible for you to visit the next node only. You couldn't go back. But in this doubly linked list, you got two pointers. One is pointing to the next node and another is pointing to the previous node. So there are two pointers, previous and next. So obviously the structure of the node will be a bit different from the single linked list. In the single linked list, we had only one pointer, but here we are having two pointers. So let's understand this structure. I'm creating a doubly linked list which comprises only of integers. In this structure node, I'm taking one integer data member. I can have strings, I can have floats, I can have any number of members also. Definitely, I should have two pointers. One should be the pointing to the next node and one should be pointing to the previous node. So this is the next is a pointer which will point to the structure of type node, and this previous is again a pointer which will point to the structure of type node. Here I am assuming two global pointers, start list and end list. Obviously, by the name only, it is clear that start list will point to the first node of the doubly linked list, and it is through this pointer that we will be traversing the linked list in FIFO direction. That means in the first in, first out direction. And end list will point to the last node in the doubly linked list, and it is through this we will traverse the doubly linked list in LIFO, last in, first out direction, that is in reverse order. These are the three function prototypes. I will be having three functions in this program. One will be create doubly list. Obviously, it will be used for creating a doubly linked list. Display FIFO. It will traverse the nodes of the doubly linked list in first out order. That is the order in which the elements were inserted into the doubly linked list. This function display LIFO will traverse the doubly linked list in reverse order. That is the reverse of the order in which the elements were inserted into the doubly linked list. You are making the start list as null initially. On running the program, you will get a menu. It will offer you four options. Press 1 to create a doubly linked list. 2 to display the content in FIFO order, press 3 to display the content in LIFO order, 4 is for quit. When you press 1, obviously this function will be invoked, create doubly list. Here is the create doubly list. See, in this function, it will ask the user to enter a certain integers and will arrange them in the format of doubly linked list. After inserting every integer, user will be asked whether the person wants to add more. If the user presses Y, it will prompt for the next integer, and this function will exit when the user presses no. I am taking one variable k of character type and it is initialized to lowercase y. This is a while loop which will execute for the time variable k has either lowercase y or uppercase y. Is the start list null? Is it the first node? Yes. The start list pointer was initialized to null. Here you are creating a new node. If you recall, it is allocating memory equal to the size of the structure node. Size of finds of the number of bytes consumed by the structure node. So this much number of bytes will be allocated and that memory will be typecasted to be used by the pointer of type structure node. And that memory will be assigned to the new node. So that means you will be having one new node that is called as new node. User will be asked to enter an integer value for this new node. Suppose user enters 5. The next and previous pointers both are initialized to null. Start list pointer is set to point at new node here, and end list pointer is also asked to point at new node. After that, whenever we will be inserting new node, end list will keep on pointing to the last node, but start list pointer will remain at the first node because this is the start list which will enable us to traverse in the forward direction, and end list will enable us to traverse the doubly linked list in reverse direction. Because if block is executed, control will not go in else. Here you will be asked, do you want to add more? Yes. It will go here. Do you remember that we have to include one blank space while accepting character from the user? You were told in the last lecture that the enter key after pressing the character can also be assumed as a character. This statement will not stop for the next consecutive value of k. By including this extra space, that enter key will be absorbed. So be careful while accepting a byte or a single character in C. Suppose we assume the user has pressed a y, it will come here. Is start list null? No. the status is pointing to some node now. So this else block will be executed. A new node is created. The new node is created. The user is asked for the integer value for this new node. Suppose the user enters 2. The next and previous nodes are initialized to null. Now you want the next pointer of end list to point at new node, and you want the previous pointer of new node to point at end list. See, the next pointer of end list is set to point at new node, and the previous pointer of new node is set to point at end list. So these will be connected. After that, end list is set to point at new node. End list is set to point at new node. So that the subsequent nodes will be connected through end list. User asks, do you want to add more? Suppose user presses Y again. Again, new node is created. New node won't be left here. It will be pointing to the newly created node. End list is still pointing at the last node which was just created. User is asked to enter the integer value for the new node. Suppose the user enters 8. The previous and next pointers are set to null because you want to connect this new node with this doubly linked list. The previous pointer of this new node is set to point at end list, and the next member of the end list is set to point at new node, and thereafter end list will be asked to point at new node. So see, the previous pointer of new node is set to point at end list. See, previous pointer of new node is set to point at end list. The next member of end list is set to point at new node. See, after that end list is asked to come at point at new node. This function is for displaying the elements of doubly linked list in FIFO order, first in first out. This is the order in which the elements were inserted into the doubly linked list. So what we are doing, you are making use of an extra pointer temp, and it is set to point at start list. So temp is set to point at start list. You are checking if the temp is not null, go inside this block. If temp is null, that means the doubly linked list is empty. In that case, it will display the message that doubly linked list is empty. But if the temp is not null, it is pointing to some node, it will go inside this if block. You will get the message that content in the doubly linked list in FIFO order is. After that, this while loop will be executed. While temp is not equal to null, unless temp reaches this null, this loop will execute. On the screen, you will get the value of the data member of temp structure. So it will display 5. After that, temp is set to point at its next node. That is, temp is set to point where the next member is pointing. The next member of temp is pointing at 2. So temp will come over here. This while loop will execute. Is temp not equal to null? Yes, obviously it is not equal to null. Print the data member of temp structure. So 2 will be displayed. Temp is set to point at its next node. Temp will come over here. Is temp not equal to null? Definitely it is not null. Display the data member. This is that it is displayed. Temp is asked to point at its next node. Temp will come over here at null. If temp is not equal to null, no, temp is null. So it will exit from the while loop. So this will display the elements of the doubly linked list in FIFO order. That is the order in which it was inserted. Because we are using doubly linked list, it is possible to traverse the linked list in reverse order also. Here, again, you will make the use of temp pointer. Temp is the temporary pointer. Temp is set to point at end list. End list is pointing at the last node. So temp will come here. If temp is not equal to null, if temp is null, that means there is no element in the doubly linked list. In that case, you will get a message. The doubly linked list is empty. But if temp is not null, it will go inside the if block. You will get the message on the screen that the content in the doubly linked list in LIFO order is, while temp is not equal to null, run this loop. So is temp null? No. It will print the data member of temp, that is 8 will be displayed. Temp is set to point where its previous member is pointing. The previous member of temp is pointing here at this node. So temp will come and point at 2. Is temp not equal to null? Yes, it is not null. Display the data member of temp. So 2 will be displayed on the screen. Temp is set to point where its previous member is pointing. So the previous member of temp is pointing at 5 at this node. So temp will come over here. Is temp not equal to null? Definitely it is not null. It will display the data member of temp. That is 5 will be displayed on the screen. Temp is set to point where its previous member is pointing. So temp will come over here at null. Is temp not equal to null? No, temp is null, so it will exit. Let's run this program. I'll be running my programs on Unix, so I'm using the Kigwin software package. Kigwin is a software package that gives you an Unix environment on Windows. This is the program that I have already created for you. This is what I explained to you right now. I'm compiling it. I'm using the GCC compiler for compiling the program. No message, that means the program is successfully compiled. Let's run this. You got a menu. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's press 1. Enter an integer value. Let's enter 1. Do you want to add more? Yes. Enter integer value. Yes. 2. Want to add more? Yes. Asking for another integer value. Let's enter 3. Want to add more? Yes. Want to add more? 4. Want to add more? No. Let's display. We'll display in the initial the FIFO order. Let's press 2. See, you get the initial order. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. Let's display in the reverse order. Let's press 3. See, you got the LIFO, reversal order. So this is the benefit of using the previous pointer also. Press 4 to quit. So program is running successfully. If you find any problem or if you want the code for this program, please mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. And please subscribe to my channel. Search for Bintu Harwani. You'll find more of my videos. And please do write comments. You're not writing comments. I need the comments desperately, so that I should know that you are understanding my lectures. And please guide me on what computer topics you want me to create tutorials on. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.